everybody, this is Jeff Brown again. This is video number 8 on the Focus on Marketing videos for photographers, how to make a lot more money from your photography. Now today I'm going to talk a little bit about wedding photography. It's just going to be a short video to give you a few pointers. I've had quite a few clients over the past few weeks who are working with me on their business marketing and trying to increase their prices from photography, and they say they have a lot of problems getting the money they want to get for photography because there's a lot of competition out there. Now, one of the major things with wedding photography is creating a brand. If you can get your brand right and if you can get your image correct, then you can charge the sort of money you want to be asking for your photography. Remember, what you've got to think about is a lot of people say, oh, I'm not good enough, my photography isn't good enough. Your photography is good enough if the bride likes your photograph. So if you get an inquiry through to your website from a bride or through to your Facebook, the chances are she's already established in herself that she likes your work, so she's happy with your work. And it's all about having the confidence to charge what you should be charging for your photographs. Remember, your bride doesn't look at the photographs the same way as maybe I look at photographs or you look at photographs, because we're both photographers. She doesn't look at the composition, she doesn't look for leading lines, she doesn't look for exposure. She looks mainly for the expression, whether the photograph tells the true story of the day, whether it shows emotion. One of the most common things I've had from bride and grooms or mothers of brides saying to me about my photographs are, wow, they're really clear. So that's not really a photography expression, isn't it? Wow, they're really clear. But they just want to see photographs that really capture the whole essence of the day and capture every single bit of emotion. And that's what you can do regardless of your level of photography. If you've got an interest and a passion for photography, you can capture that. And another thing that helps is your personality. People buy from people they like. So if you sound like you're really genuinely interested in their wedding and you're excited like they are about the wedding, then they're going to bond with you and they're going to want to book you. Now, so how are you going to make your brand a bit better, make your brand stand out? Well, there's a couple of ways. And one way I would say is, and I've worked with quite a few photographers who are a little bit mixed up in the fact that they don't know where they are with their website or with their Facebook page. And I think the main way to do it is through creating a niche. And by creating a niche, I'm saying that if you're a photographer who does weddings, you do portraits, you do pets, you do commercial, you do events, then why not look at removing the events and the commercial, maybe even the pets as well, away from your website and just having your website a wedding photography or wedding and portrait, you could call it, lifestyle website. Same with your Facebook as well. And you know, you can set up a new website on GoDaddy for something like £5, £10 a month. It's not going to cost you a lot of money. But remember, your markets are completely different. Now, like me, I'm a bloke. I've got a website and a Facebook presence that hits my customers. And my customers from my website and from my Facebook are brides aged 24 to 34, looking to spend more towards the middle to higher end range for their wedding. So when I write on the website and when I write on my Facebook page on a regular basis, I always talk as if I'm talking to those people. So I don't talk like a bloke down the pub. I talk in the same sort of language that those women would be using. So using words like gorgeous, fantastic, absolutely amazing wedding venue. So I talk about stuff they're going to be interested in. Also colours as well. Think about the colours that I'm using. So I'm using bright pastel colours. I'm using pinks and light blues, stuff that's related to weddings, mainly on white backgrounds as well. I use a lot of black and white imagery. Now, imagine if I was marketing to a completely different audience. If I was marketing to a commercial audience, I might have a completely different website. The website might be more a lot more clean, hard cut, sort of blacks, darker colours, with white text, and the text doesn't tell a story, the text just says what it does on the tin. With the wedding photography, you tell a story, you're trying to boil the sort of like romance from the whole day into it when you're making posts and when you're talking about what you do. When you're selling to commercial clients, you tell them what you can do, how you can do for them, and what the price is. And that's basically the way you do it. So you're looking at two different people who are looking. And also the other thing as well, which I've found from my commercial photography, is about 80% of the people who contact me with regards to the commercial photography in the field that I've worked in have been male. So they're a completely different type of people from who's looking for the wedding. So for me, straight away, it was the perfect thing to separate my businesses off onto different websites. So I got a wedding photography business with its own website, commercial photography business with a commercial website, and then we did lingerie and boudoir. It was very, very sort of classy. There was nothing untasteful about it, but because it was lingerie images, I didn't want those images on the same website as photographs of children, families, so I decided to move that off onto a third website and call that a completely different company as well. At the end of the day, it was still me and my photographers and makeup artists running exactly the same companies from the same address, but I had three different websites to do it. So how to create a brand. Now a brand, people instantly think of a brand as a logo. Now a brand isn't just a logo. A brand is everything your client or your potential client feels, imagines, thinks, believes about your particular company. So brands can be anything. A brand can be that they believe that you're passionate about what you do. They believe that you caring, they believe you have a fantastic customer service, they believe that you're fun, you're exciting, you're enjoyable to work with. If you can get that across into your brand, and your brand is not just a logo, it's your website, it's your Facebook, it's about every single word that you put down on your posts and the images that you use to convey who you want to be. Now if you're in a position now with your wedding photography where you're charging maybe less than what you want to, you might be charging, £400 or £500, and you want to be hitting the £1,500, £2,000 mark. There's nothing stopping you do that at all. You just need to create the brand to do it. So you need to start talking about where you want to be, about fantastic venues. You want to be posting pictures from beautiful venues. And if you haven't got wedding pictures from beautiful venues, just go and photograph the venue. Share stuff, share stories of expensive wedding cake. You can share other comments and other posts that you'll see on other Facebooks and other Googles, and share them to your new target audience. Now remember, your audience can completely change the next day. So if you wanted to aim for a high brand audience, well, what you could do is you could start marketing your photography to that audience with Facebook adverts, and that's something I'll go through in detail in another video. So by doing that with your Facebook adverts, you can target your audience to women who are 24 to 34 year old, who are engaged or in a relationship, not single or not married, because they're not going to be looking for their wedding photographer. Then you can target people on income as well. So you can target people who are on £40,000 a year, £50,000 a year. You can target them by the area, and you can target them also by some of the venues. So a lot of these big venues will have their own Facebook pages and will come up in Facebook ads. So you can target people who like that particular venue. Not only do you target people who are interested in weddings and are interested in wedding photography, wedding dresses, wedding flowers, you can also target people other interested. So you're building up, imagine that, you're building up this client, and the ideal client you want, this 24 to 34 year old woman who's in a relationship or engaged and is looking to get married, but she has a lot more disposable income. So other things she might like are more high-end products, like Michael Kors handbags, Mulberry handbags, Tiffany bracelets, Tiffany necklaces, Mercedes A-Class, Audi cars, BMW 1 Series. Think of all the stuff that would appeal to a woman with that disposable income who wants to be looking for a photographer. So see, it's quite easy to really start changing your brand. And also what you've got to think about is, at the higher end, there might be less customers, but there's less competition out there. So at the very bottom end, where 80% of the photographers are at the moment in the market in the UK and probably around the world as well, most of those cheap price photographers are fighting for most of the custom. Where if you move into the 20% bracket, yes, there's less custom, but there's a hell of a lot less competition out there. So the good chance is that, once the bride's contacted you, and if you're marketing to a bride who can afford your services, then price shouldn't be an issue. It should then come down to your personality and what they think about your brand. And obviously they already liked your photographs because they got in contact with you in the first place. So you see, it is quite easy to change your brand in really a matter of weeks, and you can start seeing the difference within a month or so. And this is something I've been helping a lot of my clients with over the past few weeks. So I hope you found this useful, and it gives you a few little pointers in which direction to go. If you'd like any more information, you can email me direct at info@focusonmarketing.co.uk. Or just drop me a message on my Facebook page. I'd love to hear from you. I hope that you found these videos informative and they give you some good information. All the videos are recorded live, then uploaded to Facebook and to my YouTube channel. So I'm sorry I don't edit them. I'm pretty much speaking off the cuff. So obviously there are a few mistakes on there. But hopefully it gets the message across, and it just means I make a lot more videos a lot quicker and get the information out to the photographers who need it. Well, thanks very much. I've really enjoyed doing this one.